Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on a supply raid that should get us a lot of nice, well, loot. Because we're actually lacking in a few areas, so that's really gonna come in handy. We need a few Illyrium cores just to see if we can't make that those last few ammo types that we're still missing. And of course the alloys and Illyrium crystals will be very handy indeed for when we need to make something else. But this is the team we're going with. Finny with the EMP rounds, Christoph with his amazing critical shotgun. And then we have Ulrich with incendiary bombs and normal grenades and armor-piercing rounds as always. Hugh! I realized that I've made a big mistake in the previous episode not taking him, because Hugh, of course, is invaluable with his healing abilities. And if we can get him up to Colonel, he's gonna get the restoration ability as well, making him an absolute healing beast. And now we have Yang with the heavy suit, the war suit. We haven't used her shield wall ability yet, but that might come in handy in this mission. She has a rocket launcher and a hazmat suit and two acid bombs. And now we have Emma, our new hacker. We're teaching the ropes, carrying an EMP grenade and the skull jack. So that's it. Maybe I'm just realizing that we're missing the mimic beacon. So I might want to swap out the EMP bomb for the mimic beacon. I do have to make items available if I want to. So make utility items available, then edit Emma and put in the mimic beacon instead of the EMP bomb. There we go. Easy as that. So here we go. So as always, we need to, on supply rates, we need to be very careful that we don't damage any of the goods, because that of course is going to reduce everything we get. There's no unknown enemies on this mission. In position to drop. There's heavy mechs and a sectopod.
Recon picked up a transmission from a disabled Advent troop transport that the Resistance locked down in this area. The aliens haven't managed to get this thing moving, so we're going in to try and seize whatever materials we can from it. They won't be happy to see us. Eliminate any hostile resistance and secure the area.
So there we go, they won't be happy to see us, of course. But Operation Mountain Strike in Western Europe. So very careful use of grenades will be required here. But I think we can manage. Also need to keep in mind that Ulrich can fire twice. I keep forgetting that. But if I don't move him, he should be able to fire twice.
The Advent troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
So the advantage we have here in this mission is that we don't have a timer, so we can take our sweet time checking out every nook and cranny. But let's just move further just to see if we can spot anybody, and I'll see you guys in a second. I think we found something.
In your belly.
That is not that bad, actually. A Lancer Trooper and an advanced mech, so that's an easy start, if there is such a thing as an easy start. Let's just put everybody in their direction so we can take care of them slowly but surely. And then we found something else. Archon, Viper, and oh shit, that might be a problem. So it looks like the base is over there on the left. That kind of skewed my perspective a bit. Because we saw those troopers, Lancer, and mech head over here to the right. Oh. And I hear the sectopod over here somewhere. So I think it's contained in this batch. So if I can, I think I should actually try and take out those three over there first before we head over there. So give me a second. So those three are heading back, so I'm going to focus, as I said before, I'm going to focus on these three guys first, trying to take them out. If I can, that would be really nicely, but I do have to be careful, because, why didn't they see her? I don't really care. So Mac, let's destroy Aldo. I do want to take out that Lancer first. Because the mech is pretty much guaranteed that I can kill it with Vinny's EMP pistol shot. There we go, 8 damage on the Lancer. And hello! I should have actually just overwatched everybody and hoped for the best, but I don't really like that tactic. Just because it just fucks everything. Okay, so that's really good. Because now that means I can just take care of the heavy mech with my EMP rounds. If he would hit it, at least.
Adjusting aim.
That was interesting. Maybe I should try, because I'm not really sure. Does that bypass his armor now? I don't think it does. So that's 8 damage, but I can do 11, so yeah, it doesn't bypass his armor. Don't know why I thought that before. Ulrich, fire at the heavy mech. Please hit it. There we go. There goes the armor, so that means I can use a pistol shot from Vinny to finish it off. Pistol shot in the face. There we go.
Did you see that one?
And now I want to be careful about this. I think I can safely... Ooh, Vinny got a promotion. I can safely fire... Maybe I should fire at the Lancer with the last pistol shot. Oh, that was a graze. That was too bad.
That won't do it.
That would have been nice, but we still have 2 shots left. So if I'm not mistaken, if I put Emma over here, she should get a nice flanking shot of the trooper, on the trooper, whatever you want to call it. 100%, hopefully critting it. Oh, he didn't die. Sixty to 42, which means I'm probably gonna have to forfeit Christoph's concealment. Because I'm gonna put Hugh over there. Let him fire at the trooper. 86. Yeah, Emma should have done that. Because she had a better chance. Is Emma gonna pick that up immediately? Yes, she is. A scope and a PCS advanced focus, so that's an aim PCS, if I'm not mistaken. And then we have Christoph, who I can put over here, but that is risky. If I see something from over here, I'm gonna be fucked, but I don't really have another chance. Oh, please don't spot anything else. Oh shit, those guys moved. Where the hell did those guys come from? Ooh, that's gonna hurt. That is gonna hurt. But if I kill the Lancer from here, I get implacable. That means I can survive at least one shot. Which means I'm gonna do something really, really interesting. I'm gonna just move him closer into the direction of... But I'm really scared of that sector pole that I keep hearing on the right. But I'm gonna get him closer to those guys, making him the most interesting target. And he should survive at least one shot. So the mech is coming closer. He's not gonna get a flanking shot. Ooh, yes he is. Oh, fuck you. That was nicely done. I gotta give it to him. That was nicely done. Now he's gonna fire at Yang, because Yang is... Okay. That could have been a lot worse than that. Oh shit. Is that thing gonna explode? Yes, it is. Let's move everybody closer. I could use face off already, but that's a 3-4 turn countdown cooldown I don't want to use, so. That's a nice shot at the mech. And then I can use Emma to finish it off if I want to. I'm just gonna put Emma here and see if I don't spot anything else, please. Ulrich, get a bit closer. Christoph, I could put you over here, but I'm really, really scared of those. As we know, there's at least an Archon and a Viper over there as well, so I do want to kill everything from over here. Hugh, he can't hit for shit. If I'm not mistaken, this should be a flank shot. Yeah, it is, it is. So that's a flank shot on the trooper. If I can kill him from over here. Is that a kill? 9 damage, that's 1 damage short, probably. Yeah, okay, but that's something I can easily take care of with a flashbang or something like that. Or the gas bomb. Can I throw the gas bomb that far? Nope, I cannot. Just one tile away. Fuck you. Let's see, I could try and hack the mech, by the way. But I'm not gonna do that. It's just too risky to do that. Ulrich, I want you to fire at the mech. Don't know if that's a good idea, but I'm gonna use you to fire at the mech. Shredding the armor, and that is actually... Was that a critical? 3 shredded and 9 damage. That was a lot. Could use you to fire at the mech, but what's Vinny's shot at the trooper? 42, that's not good. Can I make that a better shot from over there? That trooper is really in there. Hugh, since you have a shot at the mech, you might as well try and take it. Taken care of, thank you, Hugh. You're welcome. Yeah, that's target lock, probably a target hit. And then we have... Woohoo. 35, that's not good. But can I throw a grenade over there? I cannot, of course. That is bad luck. But of course, then the last thing we could do was combat protocol. So goodbye, trooper. Hopefully I'll never see you again in this lifetime. Goodbye. Okay. That's done. And I'm just gonna put everybody else on Overwatch. I don't want to risk anything anymore. So reload you and then on Overwatch, just in case. Covering fire, yeah. Because I have a feeling they're starting to move in our direction instead of the other way around. Yeah, okay, just as I thought, the Archon and the Viper and 2 Vipers are still over there. So we're just gonna have those in our faces right now. And they spread out really nicely. And I just keep getting the shivers from that sectopod that's coming closer. Could actually try running gun and take out that Viper over there. So that's something I can do. I could use Vinny. Ooh, those are really bad chances, by the way. 8 to 10 on the Archon. Might be an option. Because we don't really have a lot of those options. I think it's safe to assume that I can use my incendiary grenade right now. Because I know we killed 5... No, 6 enemies already. There's 11. So one of the 2 other guys is a sectopod and probably accompanied by another shield bear. So yeah, I'm just going to use my incendiary bomb on these guys. So that might actually kill that Viper instantly. So yeah, the Viper is dead because he's burning right now and he's going to take burn damage in the next turn, killing it immediately. And the Archon is burning as well, which is really good. Because that's always the hardest one to kill. Then Christophe, use running gun and get yourself behind that tree over there. You shouldn't be able to hit anything else. Well, to trigger anything else. And then, do I want to try rapid fire on that Viper? 96 and 92. I think I'm just going to try rapid fire. If it misses the first time, I save my ass. If it doesn't, he's not going to fire 2 times, so thank you. Thank you very much. So the only thing that's left is... Wait. Why do we have 2 alien... Oh, yes, the Viper is not dead yet. And then Implacable. I'm just going to keep him over here, I think. Although... I might move him back over here. Just so we can deal with the situation. And now it's just a matter of firing at the Archon, I think. With everything we've got. He's gonna dodge a few of the shots, probably. Not that one, apparently. 8 damage, so he's almost dead already. Especially with that burn damage applied. Because burning can actually... Hair trigger free action. Holy shit, that's the first time that happened. So let's try that again. Oh, ammo. Thank you, Vinny. And now what I'm gonna do is reload if I can with the characters that need to, and just put everybody else on Overwatch. So reload, reload, Overwatch, and I think I'm just gonna move Hugh a bit closer, because we know where we need to go, although I can't really find a good position. Goodbye, Viper. So that takes care of the Viper. Now we only have the Sectapult to deal with. Of course, not just a Sectapult. That's really, 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 really scary. But let's start moving everybody up slowly, and I'll see you guys once I spot something. There we go. Okay, I've been moving forward really, really slowly with everybody on Overwatch. And that is paying off, apparently. Oh, that shield bay is down already. So that still leaves a Lancer and a Sectapult. So please move forward, guys. Because you're still in the shadows for some reason. Yang got a promotion, which is really good. Oh, this is so scary. Please don't walk through the supplies. Oh, that is nice. An EMP sniper shot on the Sectapult. If it would... Did we just destroy supplies? Stop missing him!
I'll get him next time.
Fish hit! Yeah, shredding. 9 damage. That's really good. So you can see these guys aren't in perfect positions because Hugh is just... Is he gonna stand on top of the... Wow. Okay. I think... Yeah, we did hit one of the supply crates.
If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover once the
So we still have 3 crates left, which is good. That Lancer is really... Is that a Lancer? It is a Lancer. That Lancer is really bothering me, but we got run and gun back, so maybe we can get a shot in over here somewhere. Might be able to kill him. But Hugh... I know this looks scary, Hugh, but I need you to get closer to the Sectapult. And then... Hugh, you did really good in firing at the Sectapult, so I'm gonna let you fire twice again, because you have that salvo ability. Fire away! Wow! You really did get a damage buff with that beam cannon, didn't you? And you're really liking that, so Hugh! I want you... Oh, you have a shot at the Lancer as well from over here. I think I'm pretty good on killing the Sectapult, so I'm gonna try and get that shot, because the Lancer is bothering me the most. And we missed. No biggie, Hugh. No biggie. Happens to the best of us. Could get Yang a bit closer. I'll put her over here. I think she can see the... Yeah, she can see the Lancer over there. 82 hit and 40% crit chance. I want to take those shots. And that's taken care of. Thank you, Yang. From Canada.
What did you expect?
If you don't get that, the voice actress from Yang, from Ruby, is actually a Canadian as well. So, yeah. Sectapult, 95% chance. I think I'm just going to take that. So, Vinny, take out the Sectapult. Goodbye. But yeah, Sectapult explode, by the way.
No, that was good.
Did Hugh just take 5 damage?
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down.
Or did I destroy another crate because of the Sectapult explosion? That is sad. But I like these guys. I like this team. I mean, they're freaking amazing. 92% successful shot percentage. 1 enemy kill per turn. A new record on the average damage per attack. Ulrich was amazing in this episode, dealt most damage, Vinny most attacks, of course, with his pistol shots. Yang was under fire most, because she got... she was outflanked at the moment, but she didn't get hit, actually. And then Hugh moved the furthest for once, and not kissed off, because Hugh did some healing in this episode as well. So thank you very much, guys. You really, really earned your rest, although I'm not going to give you that many days of rest. Because we're gonna go and destroy an alien facility really soon. And we got a few promotions, look at that. 3 promotions, but a few wounded as well because of that. Very smartly put micro-missiles. Those missiles really hit their target. But Vinny promoted to Major, Steady hands or aim. Hunker down now confirms 20 aim on the first shot, I think. We're just gonna go for steady hands, because that's just a passive buff. I did that with Cedric as well. It's just the best of the out of the two perks. Hugh. That's more interesting, of course, because now Hugh is a colonel as well, and he's gonna get the restoration perk, able to heal. That would have been handy in this mission because of the direct damage on a lot of our troops. Being able to heal a lot of them at the same time is really, really handy. Gonna come really in handy. And then Yang, volatile mix, of course, so that your grenades also do 2 damage extra. There we go. Thank you very much. And then scope, advanced focus. So, focus is will. So 16 will extra. That's gonna be in handy. Gonna come in handy when we get a side trooper. And then the wrecks of everything we killed and the corpses. Alien alloys, that's actually pretty good. Because we did destroy 2 crates, if I'm not mistaken. Because the sectopod explosion at the end destroyed one of the crates as well. But that's pretty good. Yeah, thank you very much. And then the sectopod breakdown, because we didn't get the wreck in the previous operation for some reason. Because we hacked it, right? We got control over it. This thing looks like something Earth's military planners would have dreamt about controlling 20 years ago. Heavy armor, advanced weapon systems, and yet still reasonably maneuverable in the field. Because we did maneuver that around in the field. Once we pull it apart, I'm hoping we'll find a means of improving on our gremlins' designs. So that is a very interesting hint, because we can improve our gremlins with that as well. But with that done, I think we're just gonna wait for the psionic research in a second. Scientists, not now, don't really need a scientist. We're gonna continue making contact on that region.
For the East African sector.
And if that's done, I'm not gonna start building the relay first. I'm just gonna go to that alien facility and, bring down the hammer. Jazz has recovered from his wounds, which is really good. And there we go. In the desert of East Africa. Hello guys, welcome to the Resistance. Welcome to the Resistance.
Reading you loud and clear.
Reading you loud and clear indeed. I'm hesitating what I just said. Because I don't want to build a radio relay on that one. Because I want to build one over here. And I think it's possible. If I'm not mistaken, it's possible. You don't need a relay on an adjacent region to build a relay. But it would be very handy if we could do that. Although, it appears as though we can't really... Can't we go to South America from South Africa? That would be annoying. We need to make contact with that region anyway. So that's not an issue. But if that's the case, I want to build a relay over here, reducing the cost of contact over there. Because I think it kind of looks like that, doesn't it? Yeah, we can't, because these are all linked for some reason. But I can't. Yeah, I can't access them otherwise. So yeah, I'm just going to wait until the Avatar project completes at the end there and just install that radio relay right now. 4 days.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
By closely examining the aliens' own means of harnessing and wielding psionic energy, I believe the chances are good that we'll have more than enough viable candidates to serve as Psi operatives. However, with the advanced psionic capabilities we've seen from the various alien species in the field, it may not be enough. In preparation for this new class of soldiers, I've used the chip removed from the commander to study the technology needed to focus and divert psionic energy. As a result, I've developed a psionic amplifier capable of focusing and enhancing the psionic energy they will be trained to harness. Although the potential for negative side effects will be high, I foresee the possibility that our soldiers will be able to push their new powers beyond the limits of what we might have considered safe before. There we go, the Psy Lab will allow rookie soldiers to train as Psy operatives, substituting standard soldier training for the intense mental ordeal that will unlock their latent psionic capabilities. An advanced Psy-Amp, this evolved version of the Psy-Amp, channels the user's psionic energy far more clearly, enabling greater psionic strength in our operatives. Psy offense and psionic attack damage of some abilities is improved when carrying this advanced amplifier. And with that, we have done most of the interesting research. So Next up, I would like the Sectapod Rex. I'm going to do that first, and after that, we're going to go back to the Shadow Chamber and do the Codex decryption.
Our troops took to calling this large robotic unit a Sectapod, under the initial assumption that it was being controlled by a sectoid pilot. On closer inspection, we can see that is not the case. Not unlike the mechanized Advent units, which were likely derived from the Sectapod itself, this machine seems to be entirely autonomous.
I still think it's sad that they never brought back the mechtoid from Enemy Within. That was a sectoid in a mech suit. It was really, really cool. We kinda can assume that the Andromedon is kind of the replacement of that, but yeah,
I had fully expected
I really like the mechtoid. God damn it.
Aliens were conducting.
Yeah, sorry, Titan, didn't mean to cut you off there. Continue building the relay. And alien machinery was cleared already, which means I'm gonna build the Psylab over here.
Psylab construction initiated.
There we go, and assign them over there, so I can only use one engineer over there to outfit that. And then I'm gonna put another engineer, because we have plenty of engineers left right now. Inside one of the resistance comms, and that boosts it up to 4, so now we can connect to 12 regions. And if we do that with this one as well, we're gonna have plenty of stuff left. I'm gonna leave this one slot open. I'm not really sure, because we can build something there, of course. I don't think it's needed at this point. I will, if we're nearing the end of the game, just to fill everything up. But can I actually go into the Guerrilla Tactics School and buy... I'm not going to do that, because the benefit we're going to get from the radio relay is actually that that's going to be reduced by 50%, the cost of those things. So everybody recovered from their wounds, which is really, really good.
Signal's coming through clear.
And there we go, 90 supplies extra on East Africa, and we just need to make contact with South Africa to finish that off. So, South Africa, make contact. There we go.
Setting course for Sector 13, South Africa.
And that should give us the benefits we need. We can spend a few more supplies at the Guerrilla Tactics School then. Oh, never mind. Never mind.
Commander, the aliens are still moving forward on the Avatar project. Taking out that facility would deal a serious blow to their efforts.
Yes, indeed. So that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So alien facility, let's assault that thing.
Sector 5, India.
We're actually in a unique situation right now, because we can actually, if we fail this mission, we would still be able to take out the mission down below. I think that's for the black side region. But now, I'm just gonna try and set this up with, because it's only a difficult mission, we don't have that many, I think there were still 11 enemies, but they'll probably be lower level enemies. Benito, we don't need you, because we have Emma to take your place. Cedric would be nice. We still need to upgrade Cedric to the max level. And an extra sniper would be nice. We could deal with that. And then only have the grenades on Ulrich. And only one ranger. This might actually work. I'm going to try that for once. So two sharpshooters, two specialists, a grenadier and a ranger. I'm just gonna edit, make armor available, yes, and maybe just quickly gonna check. So that means I can give the Wraith armor to Cedric, and even the warsuit to Ulrich then. And then let's just give him the EMP bomb, that's gonna come in handy. Although, I wanna keep him safe, so I'm actually just gonna give him the nanoscale vest. To give him a bit of extra help just in case he gets hit, because we're getting hit more often than before. And then I'm gonna give the heavy suit. I'm gonna try this on Christophe for once. That might actually be awesome as well. Look at that, holy shit. That's actually a really cool design. Never actually saw that. So, sword, the critical rounds, so that's all we need. And then the rocket launcher instead of a grenade. Gonna come in handy, I think. And then we have the Mimic Beacon still on Emma, which is good. 3 grenades on Ulrich. I think I'm gonna give Hugh the flashbang. Just in case we come across something we need. We just really need to take out a commission that we can't kill immediately. And then... I'm gonna give him some... No, not the PCS chip. I'm gonna give him some upgrades. Because he's practically the only one who doesn't have weapon upgrades. So... He has automatic overwatch shot. So a superior expanded magazine would be nice. Although an advanced stock would be nice as well. So guaranteed 2 damage on each shot. So advanced stock is nice. And then I think I'm just gonna give him... a scope to boost, so giving him 5 extra aim on each shot. There we go. Build up very nicely, and then I just want to check out the weapon upgrades for Cedric. So superior scope and an advanced autoloader, which is of course amazing. We're not going to change anything about that, but maybe Vinny's weapon upgrades. He has a scope and an advanced hair trigger. We've seen that trigger already. I want to swap his scope out with the expanded magazine. Because, yeah, it's going to be handier if he can fire more with his sniper rifle. Just because we have those EMP rounds and the plasma lance, of course. So that's it. I think that's most of the upgrades. Look at our fancy new squad. It's an everything. We actually took this configuration out on a mission. Operation Night King. It's going to be our next mission, and we're going to take Vinny, Christophe, Ulrich, Hugh, Emma, and Cedric on this mission. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give the thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye.